Good morning and welcome to this lecture. During last week, we had learnt about the decision tree classifiers. Such methods or models for classification in which a generic model is constructed are called the eager learners. Or this type of learning is called the eager learn. Here, the target function is constructed based on the training data set which we have collected, and the test cases are then used for predicting the output. There are another type of learning models which are called the lazy learners. In these type of models, the training data set is actually stored and no generalized model is constructed. In fact, when a query is made to such a system, the prediction about the class is provided by finding similarity of the test case with the training dataset rows or records. Such systems are very important and good for the dataset which has noise or which has lot of variability. And these type are called the lazy learners, as they are not generating any model like your eager learners. Let's try to understand this with the help of an example of a lazy learner classifier called k-nearest neighborhood, or in short we call it KNN. It is actually a non-parametric method which is used for classification. The input consists of the k-closest training example and the output is the class membership, like your any other classifier or the decision tree which we have done last week. An object is classified by the majority of vote of its neighbor, and k refers to the number of neighbors which we will consider, and it is a positive integer, typically small. If k is 1, then the object is simply assigned to the class of the nearest neighbor it has. Let's go through an example and this will make our understanding about KNN more clear. Now look at this data set. This data set is for a company that produces tissues which are used by laboratories, say working in biological sciences. The company's objective, the business objective here, is to predict how well this product, or typically the types of tissue they are producing, are accepted by their clients. So what they did was they conducted a survey with their clients that how do they find these particular types of tissue which are being produced by this particular company. And these are the results. So you can see that type 1 and type 2 are not taken very well by the clients, whereas type 3 and type 4 are well accepted by these particular set of clients. Now an expert in the area indicated that the quality can be mainly dependent upon the asset durability and strength, which is the parameter for predicting the quality of a particular tissue. Now this company wants to build a classifier which can help them in predicting the type of class of the particular tissue produced. So for example, if they are making a new tissue of type 5 whose asset durability is 3 and strength is 7, so without conducting the actual survey, which is very costly and time consuming, they want to predict how well this particular type of tissue will be taken by their customers. Okay, so let's try to understand how KNN can help us with this prediction. We actually say for this particular test data set with asset durability 3 and strength 7, we want to find out how close this particular tissue type is to already given types like type 1, 2, 3 and 4. And that we can do with the help of distance measure. For example, let's use the Euclidean distance measure, where we say that distance is actually you square root of the differences between these particular types. And in our case, if we calculate this distance for type 1, and mind it, we are calculating this distance from this particular test, okay, where asset durability is 3 and strength is 7. So in type 1, the asset durability is 7 and in strength it is also 7. So the distance from our test query becomes 7 minus 3 square plus 7 minus 7, and square root of this is 4. Similarly, we find out the distance of the new test query tissue which we have with tissues of type 2. And that can be calculated by saying that square root of 7 minus 3 plus 7 minus 4 square, and that comes out to be 5 here. The distance from type 3 comes out to be 3, and distance from type 4 comes out to be 3.6. Now let's rank that the test tissue which we have is which are the neighbors to these particular types of tissues. So we can rank them according to the minimum distance. This indicates that the new type of tissue which this company has created is very similar, most similar to type 3, because the distance here is least, which is 3 here. So we say let's rank it as first neighbor. Similarly, the immediate next distance is 3.C, so we can say type 4 is the second neighbor of the new type of tissue which this company has produced. And the similar way we have ranked these particular types of tissues to the query which is being made to this particular data set. Now, if I say that the type of tissue which I want to predict is very similar to type 3, and I am just considering the first immediate neighbor, I am saying that k value is 1 and I just want to consider the immediate neighbor. So I am saying that for our particular test case, this class is predicted to be a good one because its immediate neighbor is accepted well by the clients. Similarly, if k is 2, then we'll consider two immediate neighbors, the first immediate neighbor and the second neighbor. And fortunately, in both the cases, the acceptance level of the client is good, so we can say the new tissue has a good chances of being accepted as good. And with k is equals to 3, we now have two goods and one bad. But in the probability of being good is higher here, so we'll say that if we consider k is equals to 3, then the chances of the new tissue's acceptance being good is good. Thank you.